Okay, I just wanted to do some finishing touches. This is totally optional. Really, the point of our class is to focus more on the pattern drafting and fitting. But if you want to make your finished garment look a little bit more realistic, there's a few quick things you can do. First of all, you should assign it some sort of fabric instead of the default fabric. So, you know, you can make sure all your pieces are selected, and then you can go over to your fabric library, and there are some options here. But if you want even more options, you can go to Clothes Marketplace, and they have more free options as well, or even options that you could purchase if you wanted to. If you really get into fabrics, you can buy a fabric kit from CLO as well. It's, you know, several thousand dollars, so it's not like a super cheap purchase, but you can at least digitize fabric after fabric after fabric, which could be really useful for you if that's something you see yourself doing a lot. Okay, so I'm kind of just looking at some of the free stuff. Don't really know what I want. Why don't I do silk? I don't have to pay for it, right? It's free. It's 3D. Yay. Oh, silk, even silk digital fabric's expensive. Okay, just kidding. How about if I go back to the free stuff? Where's that at? Okay. Anyways, they did post a lot of new free stuff on the website as well. So, you know, how about this vinyl, right? Why not? Okay, I'm gonna say add to bag. And then you have to have an account. And once it all goes through, you should be able to download it, and they have to upload it to CLO. Okay, maybe because I logged in, it went away. Let's try again. I think this is what I wanted. It's like a vinyl. Okay, add to bag. Check out. There it is. Okay, check out. Okay. Hey, okay, cool. So then now I can download it. Should go to my downloads folders. I have to figure out how to open it in CLO. I don't think it's that hard. Okay, maybe it's easiest if I just put it in my fabric folder that's already existing. So that means I have to know where that fabric folder is saved. There we go, I found it. So it's under, for me, this is my little breadcrumb trail of where it is. There's my fabric. So I'm gonna open up another window, another finder window. Okay, I see it's right here. And then I'm gonna go to my downloads, and it's called Swatch On Vinyl. I guess I'll just leave it that name, and we'll click drag and drop it. So it should be, there it is. It's in the fabric folder now. So now when I'm in CLO, if I click on fabric, oh, there it is. I saw it. There it is right here. Cool. That's the one. I should be able to click drag and drop it. Okay, there we go. Okay, so let's look at the object browser just to kind of double check, and our property editor as well. So in the property editor, you can change the color if you wanted. You would just have to click on the actual fabric swatch in the object browser first. Okay, there's the name. Let's see what else is good. It's rendering like metal once we do the render screen. It has a little bit of texture on it. It has a normal map, which also gives it texture. Right now it doesn't really have any color, so it's defaulting silver, but you could click that little button and change the color if you wanted as well. So there's other details you can play around with if you wanted to change it.